For today's What, Why, How, we're talking about the Airdyne bike. Hey, I'm Jeff Pelizzero from 18 Strong, and for today's What, Why, How, I want to talk about the Airdyne bike, one of the greatest pieces of equipment for any kind of sprint interval training that you're going to find on the market. It's been around for, tens of decades. There's a reason why they continue making these things, because they are one of the best pieces of equipment that you can find when you want to implement some sort of high intensity sprint in your training. Big question probably begs is, why would a golfer want to do sprints? There is no sprinting in golf, and you're basically just walking 18 holes if you're walking. Many of us are riding in a cart. The reason we want to do this is, first, number one, your exercises should not be all about your golf game. There are many things that we do in our life that don't revolve around golf, but then impact our golf game. So the better we can handle those things in life, the better we will be able to handle or continue to play golf. Riding a stationary bike or doing some sort of sprint in your training program is gonna do many great things. It's gonna improve your cardiovascular health. It's gonna improve your leg strength. It's gonna improve your pulmonary health. You're gonna be able to breathe and handle elevations better. There's a lot of different things that go into it. But ultimately, throwing some sort of a sprint into your workout program, and when I say sprint, the reason I picked this is because, to me, this can be a sprint. Running a physical race can be a sprint. Rowing can be a sprint. Walking quickly can be considered a sprint in my eyes. When I talk about sprint training or interval training, it's about pushing yourself maximally for a short period of time and then taking a little rest break. So if you think about the game of golf, many people would think that just going out and walking would be a great piece of cardio to do for golf. And yes, it is. While it gets you used to, you know, walking for long distances, the taxing part of golf is actually the powerful part of golf. The golf swing lasts, you know, under 2 seconds. And so we want to be able to quickly ramp up our power and then be able to bring our bodies back down in between shots. The bike is a great way to do that, but it's also a great way to be more efficient and effective in just shortening how much time you have to spend on a piece of cardio equipment. So if you're not familiar with an Airdyne bike, the reason we wanted to put this video together is, first of all, what is it? It's a self-powered piece of cardio equipment that has a fan wheel in the front here. So the harder you pedal, the more the fan spins, but the more wind resistance that it creates. So the harder you go, the harder the bike becomes. If you get on a stationary bike like this and you just pedal lightly, it's more taxing than a regular stationary bike, but you could pedal for a long period of time. But as you get going and as you start to sprint like we want you to, it's gonna become much, much harder, and it's gonna wipe you out pretty quickly, which is a good thing. That's what we want. We want to elevate the intensity level, get you working really hard, and then have your body start to figure out how to bring your heart rate back down and recover in between bouts. So sprint intervals are a great thing to do, especially towards the end of a workout when you're working on more of the conditioning piece. You don't want to do your sprints before you go in to lift weights. If you're trying to get strong, you don't want to do sprints beforehand, because you're just going to wipe yourself out. If you're one of those folks that goes to the gym and you do 30 minutes, 45 minutes of cardio before you do your weight training exercises, I'm going to suggest that you flip-flop those and you do your weights first, after a little warm-up, of course, get your body ready. Do your weights first, then go and do your cardio, or preferably some sort of interval training is what we normally would recommend for the most part. It's always good to have some long, steady cardio here and there, maybe a long walk, things like that. But in the sake of efficiency, going in, doing a 10, 15 minute sprint interval training workout on a bike, on a row machine, on a skier, on the treadmill, where you're ramping up for short intervals and then letting yourself rest a little bit in between, is going to be the most efficient way for you to really maximize that time. It's almost like you're going to be lighting a flame internally that's going to continue to burn calories for the next day or so. So you get a lot of benefit from doing these intervals. Just a quick demonstration of the bike here. On the bike, you've got the straps for your foot, so you not only are pushing, but you can use the top of the strap to kind of pull with your foot a little bit. You've got the handles here where you can push and pull as well. So you can either do this completely with your legs. You could do it completely with your arms too, which is a much different workout and crazy hard. Or you can use both to get the maximum amount of a push and pull out of this thing. When you're going, I want you to concentrate on keeping a nice, good posture. We don't want to round yourself over, but you're going to get the bike going as fast as you can. My recommendation is start with a short sprint. That could be 10 seconds or 20 seconds, 30 seconds, and eventually get up to where you're trying to go 1 minute at a time. You can totally change up those parameters based on either what your intent is or if you just want to mix up the variety of your workout. General rule of thumb is the shorter period of time that you sprint, the harder you're gonna be able to push. So that's great for really generating power. But if you go longer, like for a minute, you're gonna still be pushing very hard, but your body's gonna wear down pretty quickly. But that's gonna help you build up your endurance a little bit more. I would also recommend keep your interval sprint at no longer than 60 seconds. So 60 seconds or less. And then I want you to rest for either 2 times or 4 times the length of that interval. If you sprinted for a minute, which is a long time, and you sprinted as hard as you could go, I would recommend going almost 4 minutes of rest time before you do your next sprint. And you only have to do a few of them, you know, 4 or 5, 6 of those to really get a massive workout. If you're going shorter periods of time, you can do many more repetitions. But ultimately, if you do a 20-minute workout of this, that's gonna be plenty. And that's exactly what we do in our Golf Body Blueprint programs. So what you're gonna do is get on nice and tall. You're gonna start pedaling. You're gonna go as fast as you can. And then you can either continue to work a little bit in between that sprint, or you could shut it down and just rest completely. That's gonna be up to you. Kind of play around with it a little bit. But ultimately, you wanna push yourself really hard, then rest and work on getting your body to recover quickly in between those interval sessions. We'll put a couple protocols of sprint intervals down below that you can play around with in your own gym. Hopefully that helped you figure out why sprints are important for golfers and why you would want to include them. Again, play around with which piece of equipment works for you, or just go outside, find a hill, and utilize that. Either way, sprints are very beneficial for you as a golfer. Let us know what kind of questions you have about the sprints or what protocols you like using yourself. We'd love to hear any suggestions that you have on protocols that have worked really well for you. We've also got a podcast episode over on the 18 Strong Podcast about the 1 minute workout and the effects and efficiency of doing sprint intervals, which we'll link in the description below. If these videos are helping, be sure to hit the subscribe button and the like button below and let us know. We'll be back soon. Train hard, practice smart, and play better golf.